Welcome guys. So in this tutorial we are going to discuss about listening over HTTP protocol. So for that purpose we have a processor which is called ListenHTTP. So let's try to implement that. So first I'm going to create a process group which is called read HTTP incoming data in this case, and then let's enter inside this group, and then we are going to add a processor which is ListenHTTP processor. So ListenHTTP processor is going to have a base URL, and also it is going to have a port number which we need to define. So those are the two minimum entries which we need to define. By default it has a base URL of content listener. So if you do not want to make any change, you can continue to use the same base URL. So let's right click and click on configure. So base path I'm not going to make any changes, and in the listening port I'm going to change it to 8086. So when other applications are sending data to us, they need to send it to this endpoint. I'm going to add one more processor which is called MergeContent processor, because usually when we receive data over HTTP protocol we receive streaming data and we want to merge those data before processing it, because streaming data usually contains very less number of records and we don't want to process a small number of records. We want to usually do more number of record processing in one flow file. In the minimum number of entries I'm going to set it to 5, so it is going to wait for 5 flow files before it performs merging. I'm not going to make any other changes here. So let's click on apply. Let's also add another processor put file. This is going to act like a placeholder. I'm just going to disable it. We are not going to use it. I just going to connect merge content to put file so I can show you the data in the list queue. So listen HTTP I have connected to merge content for success relationship, and merge content I'm connecting to put file for merged relationship. Remaining two relationship, failure and original, I'm going to select auto terminate endpoints because we do not want to do any action for the case of failure and case of original flow files. So we are good to go. Now I'm going to start listen HTTP processor, and now this processor is ready to listen for all the incoming data. I have a curl command using which we can pass data to this processor. But in a production environment, there will be application or program which will be sending data on this base URL. So this is the endpoint which we have, which is starting with HTTP localhost, port number 80806, and then content listener. And I'm going to post data to this. Now if we get back to our NiFi screen, this is not the actual one, let's get back to the actual screen. And if we hit refresh, we can see a new flow file being added in the queue. So as you can see, a new flow file has already been received. And if we click on list queue, and if we go to view content, we should be able to see a data. So this is the data which we supplied using curl command, and we are able to see the data successfully. But now if you notice, merge processor is still waiting. Let's start that merge content processor, and you will notice that it is still waiting. It is not merging all the content. The reason being is that we have passed minimum number of entries to be 5, so it is going to wait for minimum 5 flow files before it performs merging operation. So I have created a small program using that I am going to pass all the 5 records to this listener one by one. Let me modify some of the records to different records so it should be easier for us to recognize. And remember, we already have one flow file in the queue. So, and now I'm going to pass 5 more flow files from here. So what will happen is first 4 flow files, as soon as it receives first 4 flow files, since it already have one flow file in the queue, it is going to merge those 5 flow files and going to show us the data. Let me finalize these changes and save this, and then we can run this using sh command. So this is just a simple shell script which I'm going to run using sh utility. And once we do that, all the data is going to be supplied to this processor. Now you notice all the data is coming one by one, because if you would have noticed in my script, I have added sleep of 15 seconds. So after each record, it is going to wait for 15 seconds in order to send the next record. And all those records are going to be converted here into a flow file, and then it is going to be held into the queue. So as soon as we receive a minimum of 5 flow files, then it is going to be merged into a single flow file using merge content, and then we can perform further logic in that flow file. So as you can see now, we have already received around 4 flow files. So one more flow file, and then the merge content processor is going to get activated and going to merge the content. So as you can see now, merge content is in the action and it has performed merging, and in the list queue we should be able to see the view content, and we can see all our content has been merged into a single flow file. Also, let's see some of the attribute which is updated by merge content. So if we right click on the queue again, and this time we go to view details, we should be able to see merge.count attribute which is updated to 5. So it is saying that it has merged 5 flow files. So you can save this for your audit purpose. Thanks for watching. See you in next session.